answer. Are we determined?
Yes.
Are we optimistic?
Yes.
Are we hopeful?
Yes.
And are we going to fight until we win?
Yes.
Good to hear. Friends, this is not a Brexit deal. It is an assault on the rights of workers. It is an assault on environmental and social protections that people have fought for and struggled. Let's call it what it is. It is class war from above. That is what the Tories always wage. And friends, it's our conspiracy theory. It's from the Tories' own mouth. 7 years ago, a group of Tory MPs published a book in which they said British workers were the worst idlers in the world, that too many people in Britain prefer relying to hard work. They said they, amongst them was Liz Truss, Dominic Raab and Priti Patel, who now sit in the cabinet. Another Tory, Jeremy Hunt, who cheered on slashing tax credits for low-paid workers because it would make them work as hard as the Chinese. Boris Johnson himself, who declared the weight of employment regulation is now backbreaking and called for a bonfire of workers' rights. They say it publicly. We don't need to read between the lines. For them, whether they voted Remain or Leave, they are united behind this deal, because they want to toss the rights of working people on a bonfire. And that is why we have to fight, and that is why we have to win. Take back control. That's what they said, take back control. But we know what they want to do. They want to give up control to Trump's United States of America, to strip our rights in a race to the bottom. When they talk about competing with the EU, they mean undercutting them and stripping those hard-won rights. And friends, whatever happens in the coming days, and we should say this to those Labour MPs, a small panel of Labour MPs. Labour was founded for one purpose alone, to advance the collective interests of working people. If you vote that a deal that strips the rights of working people, you have betrayed every basic reason your own party exists, and you will be disgraces, and it will be all you are ever remembered for, damned by history. But friends, they are coming for our rights, let's have no doubt. And in the coming days, what they want us to do is this. They want us to be divided and fragmented and turn on ourselves. But we're not going to let them, are we? We're going to stand united whatever happens. And we're going to fight until we turn Boris Johnson and the Conservative Party out of office. Is that what we're going to do? Because the cause of our nation's turmoil and chaos is not migrants, it's not refugees, it's not benefit claimants, and it's not all the others the Tories have spent years scapegoating and demonising for all the injustices caused by the powerful. As long as the Tories are in power, this country will remain in turmoil and chaos, and we will never build a country running the interests of the majority, not the bankers and the tax dodgers who the Tories exist to represent, until we throw them out of office. All of them, Johnson, Priti Patel, Liz Truss, Dominic Raab, the whole shebang, out of office. So friends, we will march today. And whatever happens, we won't be defeated. Because there are battles that are won and lost, but there is a war to be won. And throughout our history, if we think of all the rights and freedoms we have, if you look back at the struggles of the past, history is not a story of victory and success, victory and success. Sometimes it's setback and defeat, and then victory. Like the women who fought for the right to vote. Like LGBTQ people who fought for their rights. Like workers who fought for their rights. Like those who fought racism and sexism, who were battened by police officers and spat out in the streets and demonised by the media and the political elite. Many times it felt hopeless and they felt alone and they were persecuted and hated. But they won and history damned those they fought. And we have to have that same spirit of our ancestors in the struggle ahead. So whatever happens, remember the courage and optimism of the giants on whose shoulders that we stand. And with optimism and determination in the coming weeks and the coming months, let's bring Boris Johnson and the Tories down and build a new society running the interests of the majority. Let's stand together, let's fight together, let's win together. Solidarity.